Hello, good evening, everyone. This is Rupinder Khurana on IIHM Live Hospitality Talks. And today evening, we have another guest who is a dear friend, somebody who I've met a couple of years back. And then since then, we've been interacting. And she is somebody who's been coming down to our campus, and she comes down for the recruitments for the freshers. All right, I'm talking about none other than Ms. Poonima Kumari, who's the human resource manager at the Crown Plaza in Pune. Welcome to IIHM Live, Poonima.
Thank you so much, sir. Very good evening, and good evening to all.
Right, so Poonima, it's rare to get you on this platform. So I feel it's a privilege that today we could take some time out and speak to you, because every time that you come in and you meet us, it's mostly a hurried affair because you have so many things to do. It's a packed day where you come down with a lot of agenda on your plate, recruitment. So you go through various processes. So today, I would be very interested to know about your journey. So I'll start off by asking you as to, if you were to take yourself back when you were a student, if you can share some insight about that. So what kind of a student were you?
So I did my schooling from Kendriya Vidyalaya, Ranchi. Most of the schooling I did it from Ranchi itself. Then I chose after 10th humanities, and I was very good into history, geography, and economics. And I scored a very good marks in plus two, which makes me to land up in getting the admission in Patna University. That was that time it was a tough affair. And I was fortunate enough to get admission in Patna University. Then I did my economics honors from Patna University. And after doing my graduation, I wanted to land up something which is related to welfare office. At that time, that job was very prominent in PSUs, which is a public sector unit, especially to Coal India Limited, likewise, and IFL and ONGC, likewise. So
right now, I would want to know, as a student, how were you? Were you a very serious student, and were you always?
I was not very intelligent, but not very bad also. So I used to make my things done on time, and was going through, smooth sailing in the class as well. It was not a very tough for me. Only maths was the only thing which I always fear about, but rest other subject I was
trust good. Me, I'm sure it's a fear for a lot of people.
And after that, I did my, after doing my graduation in economics honors and getting the admission in Patna University for MBA, this personal management course. That time it used to be known as labor and social welfare. So after doing that course, people used to get easily admission or a job in public sector unit or a welfare officer in any of the public sector. And I wanted to land up into those sectors itself. So I did, this was my brand, this was my dream job. And I did completed my LSW, and after completing, my sister was actually working with NTPC, and she was posted at Farakka. So that was a golden opportunity for me to be with her, and then I joined in Farakka as a facility manager, and from there I started my journey. And again,
so it's been a long journey for you from a person who did not have any connection with a hotel today to being the human resource manager in a hotel. So I'll be very interested in knowing about your journey, various ups and downs that you may have had, and any interesting anecdotes that you may have to share.
As I landed up into facility, and I was not very happy because that time my dream job was to get into public sector, and that was also not, I could not get through. But after that, I get in touch with many other people, and my job was also, moving here and there. And then something was calling me into hospitality sector, which always has attracted me to, you know, to carry yourself in such a way that you have a, you lead others. And that quality makes me pointing myself that you should go further ahead. You should go further ahead. And luckily in 2007, I got opportunity to join with Royal Orchid Group of Hotels in Pune. And I spent there quite a long time since it was my dream job. And I was really doing very, very good. And every alternate years, you can see, or maybe 1.5 or 2 years, I was getting a good growth. Because there I joined as an assistant manager HR. And I came out from Royal Orchid Group of Hotels as an area HR manager, West region. And I spent quite good time there and I was very, very happy. So hotel industry is something which I wanted to land up after my PSU's dream job. And because hospitality is something which you are connecting with the people, which you are directly connecting with the guest. And that is something which is attracting everybody. It is not only hotels, it is related to tourism, travels, and definitely to airlines as well. So that has attracted me a lot.
Great. So your journey, when you went through all the processes over so many years, all right? So when you started off in the hospitality sector, did you have any doubts about getting into the field, being a woman?
Yes, at that time it was a lot of pressure was there from home as well and from family members. That hotel industry asks you to be 24/7 and it would be a job like people used to scare as people were not aware what is hospitality industry almost I think 10 to 12 years before. It was not that great and it was not visible to much of the people. So my thought was also in the same line that will I be successful or not, or something will go wrong kind of thing. But I made it successful because this was a journey which I have really enjoyed and have cherished my throughout the, you know, working with Royal Orchid, and definitely right now I'm with IG Intercontinental Hotels. This is something which has bring a lot of change in me. I was not like that. I have become more, what do I say? I would say that I have become more, I have done lots of, I have explored myself a lot.
Okay. So much more aware of yourself, you mean to say?
Yeah, that's right. True.
Okay. So, you know, a lot of women want to get into this industry, all right? And you, as you just explained, that you yourself had a, you know, doubt about getting into the industry, because there are a lot of misconceptions which exist. Correct. And I would say that they're truly not at all true, because, you know, it's really, really safe industry when women can come in. All right. So being the human resource manager who is not only looking after the women, you're also responsible for looking after the men who are working in the industry. So as a woman who is now the human resource manager in a leading hotel in Pune, what would your, you know, message be to those girls who are thinking of a career in hospitality industry?
I would definitely say they should definitely look forward to join in hospitality sector. This is the most required, and your dream or your career growth, whatever you are looking at, can be reached out, and whatever you are looking for your career growth and a plan you have done can be achieved while you are into the hotel industry. This is a very, very safe and very good industry where not only the, you know, women's are being taken care, extra taken care, whereas every men are also being taken care. We believe in true hospitality. We also believe in true work culture. And that's
so. Can you share some examples about, you know, how women are looked after, how the hotel ensures that their safety is not compromised, and all those, you know, doubts which people have generally, or misconceptions which people have generally. So certainly, as a brand, Crown Plaza, I'm sure, is ensuring all those aspects. So if you can share those as to how it happens in the industry.
hospitality sector, I have seen they are much more aware about what all policies needs to be in place to take care of the women and their freedom and their work culture, including the men as well, as we equally treat men and women equally here. There is no differentiation. And to ensure that nothing goes wrong or everybody who comes into the premises are, are in a safe hand, we have a policy of, a sexual harassment, which is a POSHKA. We have a drop facility for a woman. We also have a training facility for a woman and a man both, where they can exchange their ideas, they can exchange their thoughts. And while they exchange their thoughts, they understand each other and there is no hassles in, walking together. So this is one safe place you can always look for and look for your career.
All right. So whenever you come down, you've been always coming down for the recruitment. So when you come down, so there are a lot of, aspects or which you look for in when you recruit a fresher, somebody who's, undergoing a course in hospitality, when you go down to the colleges and you pick up that person. So what are the things that you are looking for when you come to the campuses and do your interview sessions?
Nowadays, everybody is getting more creative. The days is, about how much you are innovative and creative. That makes you, to get an easier path and easy selection. So whenever we are in the campus, we normally look for, definitely people are, and students at this age are very smart and they are educated. In this education, we normally look for an innovative and a creative person who can also, and flexible. So there has to be a leadership competencies, there has to be a flexibility, there has to be innovative and a creative ideas amongst themselves. They should carry themselves in all circumstances and a culture. That's what we normally look forward.
So you've had a lot of IIHN students, we interacted with them, you've had them working with you. So what has your experience been with them so far? How have you found them to be a little different from, students from some other campuses?
Definitely. IIHM students are really very, very good because I have seen they are not only focusing in the studies, at the same time, they are also focusing on their training part. They are also focusing in their culinary part. They are also interacting and organizing lots of events, which makes them give an opportunity and a platform where they can explore more. And the qualities, the individual qualities, which we normally look forward, which is a leadership quality, or you can say your individual quality comes out. And that's how you are, I have seen that IIHM students are very, very profound in their knowledge, their culture, their understanding, and flexibility into collaborating with any kind of a culture. That's very, very good into IIHM students.
So, things are very different now from, what was happening 2 months back. And we as people who are working in the industry have to change to the new normal, which is going to set in, because once the lockdown eases and people start going back to hotels and the hotels open up, restaurants open up, there are a lot of changes which need to be brought in. And we as hospitality professionals will have to ensure that all the guests who are coming in feel safe and that they should feel that their health aspects are being looked after. And similarly, for people who are working, it is also important that they feel safe working in a hotel. So what kind of changes are you anticipating or envisaging, or as a brand, IHG is going to be implementing to make sure that we are prepared for the new normal that is going to be implemented very soon?
So post-COVID, which is a new normal, which we normally foresee, is a lot of changes in hospitality and a hotel industry, where we will be having, a special demarcation done right from the gate to the security gate to the entry level of a colleague at time office. So we, IIG being a reputed multinational brand, which normally works end-to-end process, and they are guiding us with lots of training materials during this lockdown season and a period where all the HODs or XCOMs, you can say, or a supervisor has to undergo a training, which is a mandatory training that will make them understand what are the new normal process, how to interact with the guest, how to serve the guest, how to deal with the guest, how to ensure that the guests are comfortable and they have a happy and nice stay with us. So new normal is going to be very, very different as we have seen before 2 months. There will be a lot of changes and we have already started working starting with the sanitization gate or maybe sanitization station or a separate platform for signing or maybe interacting with the guests. There will be no face-to-face interactions there after that. Even the room services will get changed. Once you are logged in into the or you are checked in into the room, the rooms will be not serviced unless until you ask us, or maybe turn down services will be curtailed because we normally believe that grace privacy and very less contact, or you can say very less touch point needs to be there. So we will maintain all these things. So that's the way forward.
Yes, absolutely. Pardon me if you can just continue. Yes.
So we are doing lots of training.
I know. So the staff members have to actually learn all these changes which need to be brought in, because I've been speaking to a lot of people from the industry and everywhere. A lot of such implementations are underway. So a lot of back-end training which is going on at present, because they're all anticipating that once the lockdown laws are implemented, the new lockdown laws post 31st of May, where we are anticipating that the hotels will start operating again and will open their doors. But then there are a lot of changes which they will have to bring in. And the way we deal with the guest will definitely have to change. So there, gone are the times when we would be there to, servicing the guest at every moment of time. But then now, a lot of aspects where the guest has to help himself will come in. All right. So I'm sure that all the staff members will need to be trained, and you being the human resource manager, I'm sure you're ensuring that all that is going on for IHG and Crown Plaza. Once it opens the door again, you'll have all your staff members, equipped to, make sure that things are done in a different way and they are well equipped to do it. Right. So thank you so much for coming in actually today. All right. Before you go off, I'd like you to, address the viewers who are a mixed lot. So there are people who are already in the industry, a lot of work experience, and there are people who are still students studying, and people who are yet to join in. So your word of advice for all those people out there.
Since we are actually entered into a COVID era, and after that, there will be a new normal. And new normal will teach us lots of different things, which starts from this maintaining a distance and keeping yourself clean, keeping your hands, sanitized, and wash your hands and maintain all the hygiene, everything needs to be there. So I would like to say here that students or those who are into the industry, they should start maintaining and improvising in their day-to-day life, so that new normal is not new for them and it is a regular practice.
So I have a surprise for you before you go. All right. So I want to bring in somebody who's worked with you. All right. And he has some insights to share about you. All right. So Amandeep.
Oh my God.
If you can come in.
Hi, Purnima. Hi, how are you?
Hi, Amandeep. How are you? I'm good. Good to see you.
Pleasure is all ours.
Amandeep, so we have Purnima as our guest today. and you have worked with her. So you wanted to share your experience about her, and you had some insights to offer about her. So please go on. Floor is yours.
So yes, I mean, I remember. So Crown Plaza Pune is where we worked together, and it so happened that we joined at the same time. So I mean, I joined in the month of June, and I think Purnima joined in the month of August or September.
July.
So just 2 months gap. And you know, one thing that I've observed, Purnima, in you is, you know, it's her persistence. Now, IIG is a very process oriented company. There are a lot of processes. Everything is on the system, and everything has a traction point. I mean, there's a lot of detailing that happens at every possible point. And I still remember Purnima, you know, taking that extra effort of staying back to understand as to how these things are done. Generally, you know, during your induction time or during that incubation period of the first 3 or 6 months, there's a lot of distribution of the work that may have happened. But then, you know, Purnima took the onus onto her that, no, it's my learning and I have to take responsibility of it. And that's what I used to
so
admire.
So, Amandeep, before you carry on.
And the hotel was...
Amandeep. Yes, before you carry on. So, I would like, you know, you were mentioning that there are a lot of things which you have learned from her, all right, so which you have implemented in your new job, because you have joined us, you know, from Crown Plaza after you know, leaving Crown Plaza, and you came into IIHM. So if you can share right now, what are you working as? What are your roles and responsibilities, and what all have you, you know, inculcated from Purnima?
So my current designation with IIHM Pune is Manager Learning and Development, wherein I take care of, I'm a part of the training and placement team. So I train students at the back end behind the scenes before they go for their interviews, internship or final year placements. I take care of certain modules and subjects also for them. Hospitality technology is one of them. And I'm also support system for some other departments, whoever, you know, I mean, we are right now in the admission period. So I'm assisting the marketing team also there. So one thing that I you know, kind of take back from Purnima, or rather I borrowed from her and implemented in my life, in my professional life at IIHM, was, so this was my first academic exposure per se. I had never been into college, you know, as, I mean, at the other side. So when I moved in, I could relate myself with Purnima joining the hotel, you know, when she started off with Royal Orchid about 10 years back. And she had that spirit of, no, I have to take it on me. I have to learn. I will learn, keep on learning, put that extra effort. So that is one thing that, you know, I've always looked up to. And so her persistence has kind of admired, it is admired. And it's also inspired me that, you know, you may end up spending a lot of time in learning something, but ultimately your efforts will prove out to be fruitful. So... Thank you so much.
There's a lot of takeaway for all our viewers here, and especially people who are right now undergoing the course and are looking forward to a successful career in the hospitality industry. One thing that you have to take away from today's talk that we've had is that if you aspire to be somebody in the future, you have to be persistent in what you're doing. All right. So that's something that we are taking away today from Purnima, who's joined us from IHG as she's working as the human resource manager. Thank you so much for coming in, Purnima, today, taking time out. I know you are busy because there are a lot of back-end work which you're doing for the hotel, because you're looking forward to having the hotel reopen. All right. So thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, Purnima. It was lovely to host
Thanks,
you.
Thanks, Amandeep. Nice to see you.
Pleasure. Pleasure is all ours.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir.